kind of just a blur right now, just sitting here thinking about it, you know. It's kind of the reason you want a highlight film, so you can help remember it all.
Yeah. You know, the place goes berserk. We end up winning the thing. We go in the locker room, and I told the coaches after this, that was the most, at that time, that was the most emotional, fired up, crazy locker room I had ever been around. You know, and like when I played, we won the conference championship, but it wasn't anything like that. It was more of a relief at that time. You know, we just knocked off the number two team. I don't know, looking back, maybe a lot of people didn't really deep down expect to win that game. And when we did, you know, we won it, and we did, wasn't a fluke. You know, we knew it. I mean, we had played well, and we played physical with those guys, and we won it. And in that locker room, I mean, the feeling, I think, we kind of carried throughout the season.
The locker room was very emotional after the game. You know, we knocked off the number two team in the nation, you know. And right from then, I knew that it's going to be a great season. And, you know, in everybody's eyes, you could see it, too.
I guess the times that I remember the most from this season that I'll never forget were the times when I saw Coach Roberts cry. Because when we were playing that first game against Sioux Falls, the offense had just scored and the defense was going to go out on the field. And if Sioux Falls scored and made their extra point, it'd be a tie ball game. And Coach Roberts called a timeout, got the whole defense over on the sideline, over on the benches, and he started crying in front of us and he said, "Guys, I've never won a game this big in my life. We've never had an upset like this." He said, "And it's all on you guys right now. You might never have a chance like this the rest of your life." And I mean, there was no talking, there was no screaming, there was nothing that Coach Ells or Coach O'Boyle or anyone could have said at that point that would have meant half as much as what Coach Roberts said. And they did end up scoring, but luckily we had them on the two-point play, and I'll always remember that moment.
On the street. going. Here's to your thin red line. I'm stepping over.
But you never miss me till I got a fat city address. Non-stop talker, what a rocker. Blue-eyed murder in a size-5 dress.
Change. Nothing stays the same.
I change.
Holy shit. Breathe.
Nothing stays the same. I change. This is my chance to fly. Maybe enough ain't enough for you, but it's my turn to try.
But you never miss me till I got a fat city address. Non-stop talker, what a rocker. Blue-eyed murder in a size-5 dress.
Change. Nothing stays the same.
I change. Can you feel the
I felt that, especially the way we started out spring ball, how everyone was so confident and so ready, it seemed like. And Coach Ells said it best, I think, you know, when he said that this team, he thought, had quiet confidence, I believe are the words he used. And I think that was so true, you know, I mean, because I know I was confident, and I know, but I wasn't bragging about it. And I'm saying with all the other seniors, you know, there's so many of us that led by example, and not just seniors, you know, the whole team. And I guess over the summer, I knew that our chances were going to be really good of, you know, going a long ways, and just the whole concept of the team. I thought we just, and you know, it's, as the season went on, we just gelled.
With everybody.
Yeah, it's really cool because, like, the way we bonded, like, as a team, that's really cool because, like, when we first got here, we were all freshmen on scout team and stuff, getting our ass beat all the time. And then, so you got together as that, and then as we moved up from sophomores and juniors and stuff, we just stayed friends. Everybody's pretty close on the team, and that's really cool because, like, back home in Texas, we all grew up as kids, you know, in high school. So everybody, like, you played for each other, and that's the way it's been here. So everybody just wants to win.
I'm just trying to let everybody know that I'm there for them. You know, during the week, everybody thought I was an asshole. No doubt about it. Friday nights, Saturday mornings, I do things myself, but when it comes down to game time, that's the team, that's not individual. I want to let everybody know that I had no hard feelings. I was part of the team. I wanted to be there for them, and I was there for them, and they're there for me.
Yeah.
Holders down, the kick is up. Plenty of distance on it. It is good. Wyatt Carlson from 37 yards puts the upright, and Hastings Collins has the lead with 52.1 seconds showing on the clock.
First of all, the friends I've made here, just playing with some of these guys for the last four, I mean, these last 4 years playing football here have been the best 4 years of my life. And, I mean, just the friends I've made through football, I think that's going to stick with me.
Defense, awesome. You can't, I mean, defense, all year we were told to hit people. That's what we did. That was our job. I think we did what we were supposed to do.
Dominate.
We didn't dominate everybody. There's a few teams that we were supposed to dominate, and we did. And that wasn't in our mind to dominate. In our mind was to go out and just hit people.
And so I sort of knew good things were coming, and it seemed like we deserved to have fun this year. We were winning, you know, and everyone was working their butts off. I mean, it wasn't like we slacked off once we started winning. It seemed like the workouts got more intense, the drills got more intense. It just seemed like everyone kept improving, and it just almost took on a lighthearted attitude.
Well, I
receivers this time. And Miller wants some of the action to the right side. Gets the blocking on Fleming. Has some running room across the 40-yard line. Breaks the tackle across midfield. Inside Jones here. Pulling down the far sideline. Inside the 30-yard line. That goes back across inside the 20. When Miller is gone. All the way in for the Hastings. Got a touchdown. If he wants it for the goal line. Josh Miller all the way in for the score. That's a 63-yard touchdown run.
A lot to me, you know, coming into a program that I've only been here 3 years, you know, that means a lot to me. They would think highly enough of me to represent them. There's a lot of other good selections that I think got passed up, like, you know, Brett Rusher, people like that. But it means, you know, that your team has faith in you, I guess, and can look up to you. I don't know. I wasn't a real vocal captain, like, you know, Coach Yells has mentioned a lot of times none of our captains are really vocal. But I like to try to like lead more by example. And that's basically what I've done, you know, for my whole life, I guess.
I would, for the most part, agree with that. I think that, and there was an article in the newspaper after the Northwestern game, after we had gone 10-0, we were rated number one, that said that, you know, this team hasn't dominated teams like a normal number one team will do, but we just found a way to win every game. Played with a ton of confidence all year. You know, late in the game, in the third quarter, at halftime, when the games were close, people didn't get worried, you know, and still played with confidence. As far as dominate, offensively, I don't think we dominated a ton of people. I think we really played well, played within our means. The one game, though, the Wesleyan game, without a doubt, we absolutely dominated both ways. Up front, though, going into that game, I was I was pretty nervous. And Wesleyan had had a pretty good year. That was right in the middle of the season. They were maybe 4-2, something like that. They were playing with a lot of confidence. Defensively, they did some things that we had never seen before. They run some pressure looks and some blitzes. They had a nose guard who I think was maybe a second-team All-American the year before, a linebacker who was pretty good too. And going in, I was legitimately worried that if those two really got off to a good start, that they could really do some things. And I told the guys that. I mean, the first meeting of the week, that Sunday, I said, now we got some personnel deals going on here that we haven't necessarily seen so far this year, and we're going to have to, I told them, I said, we're going to maybe have to do some things that we haven't done. I told him, I'm not ever going to tell you to go play dirty against somebody. I said, but you got to be a nasty bastard against these guys if you want to do the things that we need to do.
Atrocity! Atrocity! Saturday for me, I'm laid back all the way until I step on the field, you know, line up in the end zone, and that for me is when I flip my switch, if you want to call it that. You know, I'm ready to play. And as soon as we run out there, you know, it's a whole different thing for me.
I mean, I know there's a lot of different...
The favorite part of the day is getting taped up and getting ready, thinking about my job, what I got to do, and watching the other team get off the bus and walking into their locker room. Because I want them to see that a little defensive lineman like myself is going to kick that big old offensive lineman's ass. We'll be right back.
shut it down!
Yeah, it really does. This is, I definitely say this is a pinnacle of my career. I tell you what, it's just a phenomenal group that we're working with, the coaches, everybody. It's a big win for us, and we all came together as a team. Unity-wise, there's so much unity here on this team, more so than I've ever seen since I've been here.
Unbelievable. I told the guys before the game, I said, no matter what happens in your life, this is something that you can take with you forever. And, you know, I've been on some good football teams as a player and some good football teams as a coach, and I don't think I've ever been on a team that had more chemistry, more cohesiveness. They really just believe in each other, and it's unbelievable. It's kind of, I don't think it's hit me yet that we've made history.
Amen. Man, we keep talking about that this game is going to be a 60-minute football game, but it doesn't have to be. It doesn't have to be. You can set the tempo right from the very first snap. Offensive line, you will set the tempo. They come out in that double eagle. They're five-man front. That's nothing new. Nothing we haven't seen before. But it's getting off the football and getting that push on those combos that you guys have done all year long against some of the best teams in the country. Making plays. Running backs. Johnny, David, just like you've been doing. Hang on to the football and refuse to go down. Wide out to quarterbacks. Keep making plays. Just like you've been doing. Defensively. Getting after it. That means Steve Kirkhoff coming up the ball and son of a bitch every down. Boyle, Coleman, Tomlinson, same thing. Every down, setting the tempo right away. Danny Williams, they start running that cage play and they think they can lure. Where are you? Where are you? They think they can run that cage play, bring that guard around the hill. He's got no momentum. You're going to pound his ass down to the backfield. There's no way that running back's going to have a yard. He's going to bounce outside and the secondary's going to be there and make the play. There's no doubt in my mind, if you guys play physical football right from the very first snap, this game will be over early. And you are the best football team in the country. You are the best football team in the country. You proved it, you proved it, you proved it. And one more thing. That's our game. You don't come down from Illinois and win a game in Hastings. You guys didn't deserve victory. Not them, let's go back.
Set some records today, boys. Let's get after it. Have a great one. Right from the start. Have a great one. Get after it. Right from the start. We'll be right back.
forget how to start a fight, and nobody can prove me wrong.
I'm right,
an anti-hero idol with a suicide excuse. A thousand other suckers who try and fill your shoes.
Thank you.
time and place for everything, for everyone. We can push with all our might, but nothing's gonna come. Oh no, nothing's gonna change. And if I ask you not to try, oh, could you let it be?